Well, good evening and welcome to our 2016 edition of Christmas at First. We're so delighted that you're here this evening. Would you take a hymnal, please, as we join in singing this carol that says, "Come, O come, little children, come worship Christ the King." It's carol number 144. Would you stand with me as we sing?
Awesome. I think this is where I'm listed to pray. I hope I got it right. I am so proud. I love this night. I'm so proud of our kids. Please join me in prayer. Dear God, oh, it is indeed a mighty day when you entered our world as a baby, God, and we stand in awe of you this evening. Thank you for your love for us. Thank you that you allow us all to be your kid. So I pray, God, that you would just be here, enjoy this show for you, and enjoy listening to your children sing and declare this truth that Emmanuel, God, is with us. God, I pray that you would give our kids and our students and our adults just gusto as they sing tonight for you. May you receive all the honor and glory, for you are worthy. In the sweet name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
The song we are singing is a traditional Irish carol. It contains the Latin phrase Venite Adoramus Ramus Dominum, which translated means, come let us adore the Lord.
Well, it is such a joy to welcome each of you tonight officially to this first of our Christmas programs at Nashville's First Baptist Church. We've decorated our house, and you have helped add to the decoration by being here tonight. Your spirit and your singing along with us just officially marks the season. So we're so thankful that you're here. If this is not your church home, we would like to ask you to take just a moment tonight and let us know how you heard about tonight's program, or perhaps give us some information. You can use the card that is inside your program and just simply let that be a part of the offering later tonight. We will be receiving an offering, and you can just simply put this in the offering plates when they come by. Here's a promise we make. Nobody's going to show up at your house unannounced if you give us some contact information. But we would like to be able to tell you about other events that are on the calendar, things that are coming up at First Baptist. And so this might be a good connection card for you to find out more information about things that are going on here. It's always exciting to see some new faces, and so thank you for coming and joining us tonight. My name is Frank Lewis. I'm the pastor of this church, and if there's anything we can do to assist you while you're worshiping with us tonight, it'd be our privilege. Let's continue to worship God.
Prepare the way of the Lord. Prepare the way of the Lord. Thank you.
Amen. Amen. Christ is born. Hallelujah. Thank you, children. Let's continue to worship as we sing carol number 110, Away in a Manger. Would you stand with me as we sing?
Thank you.
Church, one of the things that we take as quite an honor that the Lord has given to us by virtue of our location and our reputation in the community is that we get to host several things this time of year that are really community events. One of those that was so significant or is so significant to us is an event that we hosted this past Thursday night. Governor Bill Haslam was present to give greetings to members of the community who had experienced a violent homicide in the past several years. Some of those were recent victims and some were victims from as far back as 20 years ago. In this sanctuary, gathered on Thursday night, members of the community hung ornaments on two wreaths, memory wreaths, which today hang now in our state capitol and will remain up throughout the holiday weekend. It was during that event that Governor Haslam just reminded all of us of things that we've been hearing in the news in just the last several weeks. On that particular day, Thursday, there was an officer that was shot three times in Chattanooga. Thank goodness those were not life-threatening injuries. There was also the bus wreck in Chattanooga, and of course we have mourned with those families and also continue to pray for the driver of that bus. We think of the fires that have hit Sevier County, particularly Gatlinburg, I should say. Gatlinburg and Pigeon Forge and that entire community. And one of the things that we decided early this week is that we were going to make our Christmas event tonight and next Sunday night when Point of Grace is here just opportunities for us to take an offering that would go to disaster relief. Our Tennessee Baptist Convention has a disaster relief team ready to go in as soon as an event like this happens in our state. Currently they are continuing to evaluate exactly what those needs are, so we don't really know tonight exactly, but some of the funds that are being received now are going to help the first responders and the people who are going in, continuing to search and do search and rescue mission. Most homes probably had insurance, we understand that. But that doesn't touch all the many, many needs that are going to be experienced in Sevier County as people are out of work and those kinds of things throughout the weeks ahead. So I want to encourage you, church, to be generous. I want to encourage our guests who are not members here to be generous as well. The offerings that we receive tonight will not be used in this church's ministry. They will go directly to the Tennessee Baptist Convention's disaster relief. Every dollar given goes to the need that's there. In addition, there are other ways that many of you can encourage and be a part of some of the other relief efforts. Brandon has some information about the Tennessee Cooperative Baptist Fellowship's drive to raise like personal hygiene items. So if you would prefer over the next several days to bring toothbrushes or anything that could be used by a first responder, someone in the field, Gatorade, bottles of water, things such as that, then we will also make certain that those go where they're supposed to go as well. So you have several opportunities. I trust and pray that you'll be as generous as the Lord allows you. Let's pray together and then we'll receive our offering tonight. Lord God, it's hard for us to imagine the devastating loss that is felt by people who may have seen a home completely destroyed, a place of work completely destroyed, and now questions about how they're going to take care of their family's needs in the days ahead. It's hard for us to imagine, God, what people are experiencing who have experienced the death of a loved one in the tragic fires. Father, for that entire event that has touched our state, God, we pray for your mercy and your grace, pray for healing, pray for comfort. We know that there are going to be many, many needs, and so financially, as we have the opportunity, God, help us to be generous, and as we give our offerings, and we know many other churches and universities and other organizations in town are doing similar kinds of things. Father, somehow use these gifts to demonstrate the love of Christ to those in need. We pray these things in Jesus' name.
Star to a place unexpected. Would you believe after all we've projected? A child in a manger. Lowly and small, the weakest of all, unlikeliest hero, wrapped in his mother's shawl, just a child. Is this who we've waited for? To romance a world that has torn all apart.
Peace I leave with you, peace I give to you, my peace not of the world I give you.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth, goodwill to men.
The Prince of Peace has come.
And all is well.
Thank you.
all is. God is on his throne, and he's in control. Maybe things that are happening in your world or in your life that would threaten you to believe that. But the truth is, he is on his throne. Let me tell you just briefly a couple of things on the horizon. Next Sunday night, we'll gather in this place for the Point of Grace portion of our Advent music. It's going to be a great night. If you know anyone that's not here that you'd like to invite, then let me encourage you to do so, and let's pack the house next Sunday evening. And then the following Sunday, the 18th of December, we'll be gathering here for our Carol Candlelight celebration. That is always, always our highlight of the season. If you're here tonight thinking this was the best it gets, then please come back on the 18th. You'll be glad that you did. We have two Christmas Eve services planned on Christmas Eve, one at 5 o'clock in this room, second one at 8 o'clock in our chapel. Both services will have communion, lots of carols, candles. You're going to be glad that you were here for that as well. So plan to join us. And then one service on Christmas morning that we invite you to join. It's been good to have you here tonight. Thank you for making this a very special night for us at First Baptist. I think our choir has done a wonderful job. Let's give them another round of applause.